Hey MHS, welcome back. It's May 6th and
as you can see, it's snowing.
Literally. And it's literally spring.
It's springtime. Like what, 1-2 weeks left of school? And it's snowing. Come out and enjoy the beautiful weather.
Yeah, come make a snow angel.
Springtime in the country. Each time I'm shocked by the light, the world lying fallow, and you are apart from me. Everything in my vision is movement and life. Riverboat, wheelbarrow, wildflower, and barley. Springtime in the country. I can smell summer on its spread. Low and harrowed lie the fields and the heart of me. Everything in my vision, departure and death. Riverboat, wheelbarrow, wildflower.
Hey Mountain, it's Sebastian. I'm here with Kayla. She's here to talk about the car show.
Hi, thanks for chatting with me. I wanted to make an announcement about the car show because it's coming up next week already on Friday the 17th. What we're going to do is you come to the regular school parking lot. I'm going to have spots blocked off for those who registered for the car show. You need to register with this QR code or this forms link on the bottom of all these flyers so you can see them all over the school or come and talk to me. And I need you to register because we print out these papers to put on your windshields. Because during the car show, we're going to have people walking around voting for the top three coolest, bestest cars. It's kind of funny, though, because it's student-led, so not always the coolest car wins. Sometimes the crappiest car wins, which is funny.
Yeah.
Like, it's just whoever gets to decide, right? But what's really neat about it, it's the fourth year that we're doing it, the fourth annual car show, and it's free for students, but we have sponsors by Napa Auto Parts, Burt Brothers, and Valvoline are sponsoring it, so there's real prizes for first, second, and third place. And just by coming and putting your car in the car show, you get a swag bag with a bunch of cool stuff from those sponsors. Like, it's just a really cool opportunity. And I'm really sad right now. Do you want to know why?
Why?
I only have 8 cars signed up for the car show.
I'll sign up a car.
Okay.
Actually, I'll sign up a truck.
Okay. Well, I mean, whatever vehicle you'd like. Last year, we had 30 signed up, and it was really cool. We filled the whole parking lot. I'm going to have Ferrari come and bring some Ferraris. Don't worry. They're not a part of the actual contest. Like, it's always just going to be students in the contest. But it's still going to be cool to look at other people's cars, right? But only students can win the prizes. Don't worry. But anyway, please sign up. It would be really sad if there were only 8 cars. It would be cool for them, though, because it would be easier for them to win the prizes. But yeah. It's going to take place after Friday classes. So there's going to be shortened Friday classes on Friday next week on the 17th. And then after those Friday classes is when we do the school barbecue, yearbook distribution, and that's when the car show is happening. So
I have a question.
Okay.
How are you getting Ferrari to bring Ferraris here?
I have hookups. Don't worry about it.
Okay.
Tires.
Thank you.
Hello, everybody. This is Ellie at Mountain High. Well, no, we're not at Mountain High. We're at the train station because,
as you can hear,
as you can tell, that's not the train we're getting on, though. We gotta go. The trains is here.
Hi guys, it's Mahina. Right now we're on the way to Orem and hopefully see some more of our students, but we'll see. Yep.
Hi Mountain, it's Alex and
Mahina.
We just got off the train and walked for 2 miles in the freezing rain to come to the Digital Media Arts Festival.
The train ride wasn't fun. It was super shaky. I was by very loud people, including Kiefer. So
my train ride was fun. Me and Sakai sat up and we just looked out the window.
Oh, yeah. Listened to music. There was a lot going on through that window, huh?
Uh-huh.
Like,
oh, it's an award ceremony. Are we winners?
We'll see. Stay tuned.
Stay tuned.
Our second place winner from American Fork High School is Tanner White, David Skinner, Lucas Coleman.
Devin, take one. Marker?
Okay, great.
Nailed it. I'm Devin Graham, also known as Devin Supertramp. I'm a content creator. I have a YouTube channel with 6.4 million followers where we travel the world doing extreme sports, to video games in real life. Sorry, I touched the mic.
No, that's okay.
And this is what I do for a living. So it's been fun and adventure all around the world.
Okay. So we just want to ask you some really, really quick questions. What do you got to say to people our age? Because you were barely older than us when
yep.
you started doing this. So what do you got to say to us? What advice?
I would try as many different things as you guys can and figure out what you love to do. So don't just settle on one thing, but try, test the waters, figure out that one thing, and then is it something you can do for the rest of your life and never retire? Like, if you're okay with that, then I would pursue that one thing and do it with everything you got.
Okay. Any advice to any young filmmakers specifically, that because you're a filmmaker?
Yep.
Anyone who's just starting out, same place you were, anything you got to say to them?
Yeah, so filmmaking isn't something you do by yourself. It's something you do as a community. So I would look around you and see the other people that are just as passionate about creating as you are, and then hold them as close as you can and create with them. But look for the people and then create opportunities together.
And one last quick question. If you had to pick, what's the coolest thing you've ever done?
The coolest thing? One of the things that was pretty cool at the time is we built the world's longest zip line in Panama. We couldn't get permission to do it in the U.S., so we built a zip line 14,000 feet of rope, I think is what it was. We did it over the highway where we had to shut the highway down in Panama. So that was like one of the more cooler things. We've done some size out of airplanes, off cliffs, so there's definitely a lot of different things we've done.
Check out his YouTube channel. It's really cool. Okay, I think that's it. And thank you so much for talking
thank
to us
you guys,
today
and
this interview.
Have a good day at class.
Woo-hoo!
Peace.
Suckers.
Action.
Get my card back.
Come on.
I'm here with Jennifer. She's here to talk about the cap and gowns. And then what's going on for graduation.
Okay, this is super exciting. So the caps and gowns are coming in and we have almost everybody's here. So good job seniors on getting your caps and gowns ordered. My office is kind of turning into graduation central because it's coming pretty quick. So graduation is on the 23rd of May. It's at 11 o'clock at Clearfield High and all of the graduates need to be there and be checked in between 9:45 and 10:30. If you're a senior and you haven't picked up one of these graduation order forms, you can get these at Sandy's desk and it's got the information that you're gonna need if you wanna order like announcements, if you want to order a yard sign. Okay, so yeah, if you wanna order a yard sign, you've gotta order that by next Monday, the 13th of May. And then get excited for Senior Week. That is coming up the next week. That's going to be so exciting. We've got the senior breakfast. We've got the senior field day. So congratulations to you seniors and go Mountain.
All right, we're here in the library with Cheryl and I've noticed there's no books up here. So I was just wondering what this display was about.
Well, this display is just kind of a little game and it's about Olivia Rodrigo versus Catcher in the Rye, which is a really famous book about a teenage boy who is in pain and suffering, and he's talking about it in this book, which is kind of what Olivia Rodrigo does in her book or in her music. So anyway, these are different quotes and you just read the quote and guess which is which. So
all right, so
people
let's
are
see.
Always ruining things for you. Is that Olivia Rodrigo or Catcher in the Rye?
I think that's Catcher in the Eye, or Catcher
in the
Rye.
The
Hey, good answer, good answer.
That's right.
So that's what this is. So come in and play the game and see if you can tell the difference between Olivia Rodrigo or Catcher in the Rye.
It's the end of the school year. Everyone's probably wondering when library books are due, so.
Yeah, library books are due now. They've been due for a little while. But what I wanted to tell everyone is, if you're worried, like you've had your book out for a really long time, and you think, man, when I bring it back, I'm going to get this huge fine, that is what I don't want you to worry about. There's not a fine as long as you bring the book back. If you don't bring your books back, then you just get charged for the book, like you've lost the book and you get charged for the whole thing. But if you bring it back, the charge is nothing. So bring all your library books back. And I want to show you how you know if you have a library book out or not. One is you can check in my DSD and it will be listed there. And you can also check another place. So
follow us. You can see I have a book here. Got to turn one in. But this is the list. If you have any books, come check. Bring your books back to the library.
Thanks.
Go Mountain.
Good morning, Mountain High. Thanks for watching this episode, this trending video. Have a good rest of your day. Goodbye.